Welcome, my dear friends. Myself, Dr. Darshit Soni. I am practicing at Baroda since 2004. First of all, I am very thankful to Dr. Ghanshyam Kalatia, sir, for giving me an opportunity to share my ideas on repertory with you. So, first of all, I would like to say a few words about repertory. The first things comes in our mind, then what is repertory and why the idea of repertory came in our homeopathy. So I would like to say that the meaning of repertory in Latin word, in no common repertory word, it is derived from the repertorium Latin word. It means an inventory, a table, or a compendium where the contents are so arranged that you are easy to find, you can easily find it out. But in the repertory, particularly in homeopathy, it is an index of the symptoms of our Mother America with their corresponding homeopathic medicines arranged systematically and logically. So in this repertory, the symptoms are arranged systematically and logically, not haphazardly. So we can easily find out, and if we are habitual to use repertory, it becomes very helpful for us in our daily routine life. So now the next question is, why do we have repertory? We know that our master, Dr. Samuel Hahnemann, sir, proved 169 remedies during his whole lifetime. And when he proved lots of drugs, then also there are many polycrase drugs like arsenic, sulfur. In each drug proving, we'll get more than 10,000 rubrics, or we can say proving symptoms. And it is very difficult for us to remember each and every rubric or drug proving symptoms. So we can come to the medicine very well easily. The need of repertory was there. Repertory cannot take the place of Mother America, that we all know that, but it is a tool to get easily to a group of probable, or we can say more suitable remedies. The final selection of the similium is based on the Mater Medica or proving, not on the repertorial base only. Because if we are giving the medicine directly, which is coming in the totality on the higher side, and it is not covering the rubrics, or symptoms are not matching from Mater Medica, then there may be chances of error. We may get failure in such cases. Repertorization method is not only mechanical method, but it is a scientific and intelligent one. And it requires deep understanding of our medicine, Mater Medica, rubrics, and all. So I can say that the repertory is our chief instrument of being exact and accurate, but with a deep understanding of repertory. When to use repertory, which repertory to be used, that also depends on the case taking and the way case is presented in front of us. Nowadays, there are lots of different ways in even homeopathy, like classical way, sensation method, Dr. Praful Vijayakar's method, and etc. There are many other ways. So we can come to the remedy by many means. But repertory, the traditional way, is always helpful, and it is very important in our daily practical life. As we know that repertory is simply an index of our material medica, the rubrics must be in their simple language. So the repertory is complete, or any repertory which contains the rubrics, they are given in the simple language, so anyone can understand easily. Process of repetition is also an art, and it requires continuous practice, patience, and proper attention to be mastered in this art. So any art cannot be learned easily. It takes lots of time, dedication, and even we need more and more practice with patience and with proper attention. It is a practical subject. It is impossible to master unless we try it our daily practice. We must use it more and more so we get more interest in doing that repetition and all that use of repetition in our daily practice. So the question arises in our mind, what is the purpose of repertory? So repertory helps us to find exact or indicated remedy very quickly. Without help of repertory, we cannot easily get to the most suitable or we can say exact remedy to our patient after taking detailed case and even after analyzing. It is also helpful and it gets us speedily review and it gives us speedy review of our many drugs. Even the grading of symptoms are given in the repertory that also help us to interpret the intensity of the symptoms. Repertory narrow down the fields of selection of the remedies. It helps in comparison between similar medicines. It also serves as a reminder. Repetition may lead us to many medicines which are not thought of during the case taking or during case analyzing by us. It also helps to find out complete symptoms. It is not easily available in any other materia medica or any other proving symptoms. It refreshes our knowledge of materia medica. There are various kind of repertories and they are based on different philosophies. Normally, we see that in Kant repertory, complete repertory, synthesis repertory, the concept is on basis of generals to particulars. And while in BTB, BBCR, the philosophic concept is on the base of totality. In BTB, the doctrine of analogy and concomitance is more given, more suitable for that. While in BBCR and bogus synoptics, it is based on the complete symptoms, concomitants, and pathological generally. We also know that there are concordance repertories, and in concordance repertory, there is no any distinctive philosophy, but the rubrics which we find during the proving, they are given in their simple and pure language of the in the pure language of the repertory or sorry pure language of the proving symptoms by the symptoms given by our prover. So these repertories are Kant and Nair repertory and concordance repertory. So these repertories are not for the purpose of reference and not it is for the purpose of reference, not for the systematic repertorization. There are many other clinical repertories like clinical repertory appended to Boric's Materia Medica JH class. They covers the whole body symptoms. And there are other repertories like repertory of the diseases of the specific parts like Morgan's urinary organs, Minton's uterus, Barry's eyes, etc. There are card repertories there also there. Nowadays, computer repertories are also available like CARA, RADAR, MAC repertory, or we can say Synergy Omelic software. Method of repertorization. There are various methods of repertorization. They are derived by our masters. So our Bonnie Hussein sir, he used the method of repetition which is applicable more on the physical symptoms and can be arranged as a few complete symptoms. So the repertory which are organized by or prepared by Boninghusen sir, that is dependent or depending on doctrine of grand generalization, and that to make the symptom complete, the local modalities and sensation pertaining to one part should be applicable to the other part. That is the doctrine of grand generalization. So what is true for the part, that is true for the whole. So when the presence of concomitant symptoms and general symptoms are lacking, we can use the Boninghusen method. Kant's method. It is applicable when the case is more general. We can say more mental generals and more physical general symptoms are available in compared to characteristic particulars. So when we can get more mental generals and physical generals, it is applicable, or we can use Kant method in these cases. In Bogart's method, cases with causative modalities, pathological generals, and or particulars with concomitants. The same way clinical method is also there. As we know, we get to know about, there are different gradation given in the repertory. In Kant's repertory, the gradations are given in three grades. Bold letters, the rubrics, followed by the medicine's abbreviations, they are written in bold letters. So they are of first grade, or we can say 3 marks. Italics are 2 marks, second grade. Ordinary Roman, that is 1 mark and 3 grade, we can say. Same way, in Boninghusen's repertory, the gradation was given in 5 different grades. Capitals are 5 mark, or we can say first grade. Bolds are 4 mark, second grade. Medicine written in italics are 3 marks or third grade. Roman or 2 marks, we can say fourth gradation. And Roman with parentheses, these medicines are of first mark and fifth grade. Many times we get confused that how can we learn repertory. And there are many ways. Many times we feel repertory is very dry subject because there is no practical applicability as we see in our college life, because practically we are not able to get this utility. So there are different ways. What I can suggest during the learning the repertory, that is, we can read a few rubrics daily and try to understand how patient can express to us. Many times we see in our daily routine, patients are saying that I cannot lie down on the right hand side. So even it is very easy for us to get in repertory, to lie down, impossible on the right side. The same way many of other rubrics that we can find it out, and we can try to search in the different repertories. We can find single remedy rubrics also in each and every repertory. So that is also useful for us, and we may have that practice. So many of the remedies are very easily we can come to know. Mind rubrics and their meanings, and convert it into the language of the patient. There are, it happens many times, we are not knowing the exact meaning of the rubrics. So we can take rubrics and we can understand its meaning exactly. So we can guess how, or we can say how patient can express these cases, or can say in his own language. Rubrics and their cross references. So each and every rubrics are given with cross reference. So many times we can get many others cross references in the cases, in the repertory. So we can easily come to the rubrics or medicine derived in their cross reference. differentiation or similar looking between similar looking rubrics like absent-minded and absurd. As we know that both are looks very similar, and even they are given near to, or even in the cross reference also we can get. So absent-minded is a rubric we can take only when the patient is not observing thing. He is not occupied with any thought or anything, and he is just absent-minded. While the absorb we can take only when a patient is occupied with some kind of thoughts or some kind of thinking going on, or anxiety or whatever he is having, but he is absorbed in some kind of thoughts and he is not observing in presence. So we can take absorb in such case. Many a times we can find different sections available in the repertory, and each and every rubric are not written in same repertory with same subcategorization or subsection. So if we generally take the food and drinks, say then in canned repertory it is available in the generality section, while in phatak there is no any generality section that covers the food and drinks. So in phatak repertory, if we are familiar, we can get this food and drinks desire and aversion under different section, that is from cravings and aversion, and for particular food that we can have. So let me give some example through which I can say that what is the importance of repertory. Case was there, he was 37 year male and he was diagnosed as pancreatitis. He was on regular allopathic treatment. Though he was on medications, there were intermittent acute episodes of the pain in between, and he have to hospitalize for acute episodes. While taking history of this patient, when asked in detail about this pain, he says that my pain starts from the epigastrium and it encircles and extends to neck. Even abdomen feels heavy with gas, and he feels like everything is get stuck in the abdomen. He was a manager, and as he says that I have to sign a regular sign many of the papers daily basis, but he can't sign continuously. After signing few 5-10 signs, his hand gets stuck. So for further signing, he must have to take rest in between. Even while asking about his dreams, he says he is having dreams of snakes. The snakes are in lots of number and they are around him, and he is standing in between them. There is no way out. Wants to run away, but he can't. So I am not able to move. I feel stuck. The pain as if something stuck in the abdomen. Feels like gripping and cramping. Pain is like something obstructed in a pipe. So while taking his case in detail, when he was asked, just describe about your pain, what you feel, what you experience, then he was saying all these symptoms, and this was his narration. He says that I don't think I will be cured from this pain. This case says it remains lifelong and will not be cured. So when I repertorize and analyze this case, I took lots of rubrics, which if we usually take abdomen, inflammation, pancreatitis or pancreas, then we get lots of medicine. We can say they are in higher grade, belladonna, iris. So it is very usual that we can come to iris or belladonna. But while taking this case in detail and as per analysis, I focus on the peculiar characteristic symptoms which I found in his case, and the pain was very typical. That's why I take these rubrics. And when I found the first rubric in the repertory, there was only single remedy rubric. The stomach, in the section stomach, pain, cramping, gripping, extending to sides through both around the back. Stomach pain, cramping, gripping. Stomach pain violent. Mind despair, pain with stomach in. As he was saying that the pain will be lifelong and I am not going to get out of this pain ever. And he is having that despair. He was also having a vomiting of bile during these episodes. So when I repertorize the case, and the first rubric which I take, that is a single remedy rubric, and it gives me an idea. I know that the case was taken on the depth, taken on in detail, and my knowledge of classical method with sensation of stuck, block, that also helps me for the final selection of the remedy. But if anyone who is not familiar with this method, then also a proper way of repertorizing, scientific and artistic, it helps us to come to the medicine which is not in our mind. So when I put all these rubrics in the repertory, I get medicine that was cochlearia armoracea. It covers all five rubrics, and there are other medicines, arsenic, chamomile, nux vomica, phosphorus, ferritum, etc. Belladonna is also there. But when I read it from our Materia Medica, Bodix Materia Medica, that stomach section, it was written that violent cramps from stomach through both sides around the bed. That was very peculiar and characteristic symptoms. But with the help of knowledge of our other method also, like classical method and sensation method, I come to know that this the expression of the patient is of plant remedies, sensation, sensitivity, and the medicine which comes from the cruciferous family. So I also see that in cruciferous family, there is a feeling of obstructed, stop, block, stuck, and there is no way out. And after this repetition, I give medicine that was cochlearia armoracea 1 mg, and patient feels very much better. Gradually, there was a need to give repeated dose of 1 mg potency in between, but his obstruction during signing, his episode of recurrent episode of pancreatitis, that also was lesser with the help of medicines. Let me say one more case. He was a 40-year-old male patient. He was presented with history of headache. He was hypertensive and blood pressure was 180-90 mm of mercury. He was narrating his complaint and says that all the ailments are started after the death of his one friend. Patient consulted allopathic physician after that, and he was having that fear that I may not get any such disease or any acute ailments, like due to that I may have paralysis or I may not have any disease which can make my life better. So when I take the case, the things came in our case taking. He was having a fear, lots of fear of evil, something will happen to me, something will happen to my, I may get brain hemorrhage, I may get paralysis, or I may have heart attack, or maybe it may be fatal to me. I may die. Fear of being alone is always there, and particularly at night. He says that if I am home alone, I cannot get sleep. I never stay alone at home. And he says his wife is at home, then only he feels better. If anything happens to me, she will take care of all that emergencies. Many times I feel fear of falling while traveling or riding two-wheeler. He says that I am also not able to take bath in the river due to fear of water. Asking about his dreams, he says he is having a dreams of quarreling or fear or scared that I will be caught by the police. Dreams of disease, illness. Fear, if I am going to drink water, someone is besides me and I feel fear and I don't go to drink water. I may need support or help of someone who can come with me so I can drink water. He is also having a fear of darkness. I never go alone in the dark. Fearful since childhood. He says that he must need his wife besides him, and many times he holds her for the support. During this case taking, I asked him that which is the happiest moment in his life. He says that before 3 or 4 days, I was there with my friend in his farmhouse, and there was a swimming pool in his farm, and I took bath. That was the happiest moment in my life. So we came to that. He was having that fear of bathing in the river, but in swimming pool, the quantity of water, we know that, but he is having that happiness that I come and I go there and I can take bath. So when I analyze this case, I found that there is a lots of fear. Even a 48 years old male, he is having a fear of darkness. That is very peculiar. And in whole case, we get that fear of darkness, fear of evil, all fears are there. So after taking all these rubrics, fear of darkness, fear of water, anxiety with headache, dreams of quarreling, clinging, and when I put it in the repertorization, the remedy comes was stramonium. As we know that stramonium is a very fearful remedy, and there are lots of fears in it. I gave him stramonium warning. After that medicine, after 1 month, patient was feeling 75% better. His fear and all that anxiety is also reduced. Sleep was sound. Now he is able to sleep alone without anyone present in the home. Blood pressure also comes to normal, and the dose of antihypertensive was also tapered. And after this follow, he was continued with the SL for 1 month, and gradually he was improving. So this is the beauty of homeopathy. As we know that if we are usually not observing many of the cases, and if we take it very lightly, mechanically, then each and every time we may come to the remedies which are polyclased and which are more easily covering the many of the symptoms. But artistic way and the proper case taking, detailed case taking, it leads us to the many peculiar characteristic things which helps us, and we can come to the exact similima which is not generally be found in only polyclased remedies. So this is what I can say with my experience or whatever small knowledge I am having in homeopathy. That's I try to share and try to convey to you all. Thank you. Thank you very much.